Israeli Defense. Mr. Moshe Patael is a bachelor of computer engineering from the Technion and has an MBA from the Tel Aviv University. He's working in the missile defense organization for many years and performed many, many activities. And I'm very proud to deliver the.
Thank you very much. Thank you, guests. It's a great pleasure to be the first presenter in this conference. Let me start with the explanation a little bit, what is going on with our neighborhood. What we are facing during the recent years are more and more accurate missiles that are actually dangerous the state of Israel. We are talking about more quantity, missiles that are more accurate, and that ranges are becoming bigger and bigger. Just to take an example, the capabilities of Iran to launch the Imad, the Ashura, the Gader H, and some others, or capability that they have to launch a cruise missile like the Sumar or the Karar. So we are facing more and more threats coming from all the arena, either from the north, from the Hezbollah, or from the Hamas. What we are facing also is that the knowledge of our enemies that they know that we are building missile defense systems, and because of that, they are concentrating on having more accurate threats compared to quantities or to statistical kind of weapon. For that, we build in Israel the multi-tier defense layers that consist on the lower level, the Iron Dome, for medium to short range rockets. The David Sling as the interim for the medium to long range missiles and also against cruise missiles. And Aero 2 and Aero 3 as an upper tier layer for long range ballistic missile defense. Our layers kind of missile defense supposed to give overlap protection to the threats that we are facing. A generic missile defense system consists of some elements. One of the elements, of course, is sensors, and we are using a lot of sensors and overlap sensors in our systems, even if it is the ground sensors, elevated sensors, RF sensors, IR sensors. Of course, we have the launch array with the range of interceptor that we are using, and command and control, even if it is one or two or more, that actually control all the activity of the missile defense. The Israeli missile defense, as you see here, we are having the Aero 2, which is operational since 2000, and continue to do a good work, and we are continuing to progress the system, the Aero 2, and all the relevant subcomponent of the system. And of course, Iron Dome, which is operational since the year 2011. We are approaching towards IOC with David Sling weapon system, which we are very proud of the progress that the system has been reached during the recent year, and with the Aero 3 that will be converged into the Aero missile system as the upper tier layer. And of course, we need to integrate the new interceptor, and to have all the modification needed to adapt the new missile or the new interceptor into the system. What I can say is that we are building a lot of overlap sensors and a capability that we won't have any single point of failure in the system, and there are a lot of interconnection between all parts of the multi-tier system in Israel. I will explain what is going on with each of the systems. So AO2, as I mentioned, is operational since 2000. We call it the intermediate tier for intercepting medium and long-range TBMs. It's endo-exo atmospheric interceptor with a fragmented warhead. It has a very large defense footprint. And from day one, actually, from the first day that the system was operational, we have the capability to have communication, what we call interoperability, with US systems. AO3, it's an exo atmospheric interceptor with a unique divert capability. We had a very successful flight test in the end of last year, 2015. The aim design for AO3 was to have to minimize the leakage rate of the system, to have shoot-look-shoot capability, especially against long-range threat. We have here a very large defense. We're using the same canister as AO2 and the same launcher with some adaptation. So it will be very easy to integrate it into the AO2 system. And again, we are talking about exo-atmospheric interceptor with a lot of capabilities. Davislink. This is a lower tier defense system to intercept short and medium range targets and the cruise missiles. It has capability to intercept also long range targets as a second tier. It has a very high intercept probability, very high agility and maneuverability of the missile. It has a lot of capability to handle salvos. All-weather operation, large defense footprint, and we are using as ground sensor, also elevated sensor to help us to counter cruise missiles threat. And here again, I would like to show you flight test that was conducted at the end of 2015. We had a series of interception flight tests that all of them were successful. What you will see here is two of the major interception flight tests against representing target. This is the Davislink interceptor. This is the launcher. By the way, the launcher was developed and produced by Raytheon together with Rafael. This is the Golden Hammond, the command and control of the Davislink weapon system, produced by Elbit. This is the MMR, the radar that was developed by ELTA. This is the representative target. This is the Davislink interceptor. You can see that the interceptor has a kind of a dolphin shape in order to help us put different sensors on the interceptor. Both of the interceptions were hit to kill. This is the standard launch, again, a different angle. Iron Dome. We are very proud of the Iron Dome system, operational since 2011, after 3.5 years of development. The missile designed to intercept and destroy rockets launched against a defended area. Low-cost interceptor with high efficiency, capability to handle salvos, also mobile and robust, and capability to have a selective activity against what to intercept. Since it was operational, we have more than 1,500 of operational interception of the Iron Dome system. And what you can see here is a flight test that we conducted against UAV, and we are planning to use the Iron Dome system forever it can handle. Because this is our most economic system in order to handle threats, and for targets that the Iron Dome can handle, you prefer to launch Iron Dome instead of other interceptors, of course. Another program that we have in our architecture is the Israeli testbed. We're using it for joint exercise along the year. We are building our concept of operation, validation, and training. And during the recent years, we are using it as a preliminary architecture design tool for helping out to do system engineering and building our next operational blocks. The ITB is being developed by Elbit, and we are having a location in the Holon area and also in Huntsville, Alabama. And the ITB helped us a lot in order to do a lot of exercises and testing the ability of our architectural studies. Again, all of what we are doing was with our US partners. I'm very glad to work with the Missile Defense Agency more than 25 years and to have their continuous support along the years. In this table is sitting Mr. Scott Shifrin, which is the Israeli Cooperative Program Office from the Missile Defense Agency. He's my partner in the Missile Defense Agency. We are working very closely, and for them, the work with us is not just a regular job of coming and building a system. They are really feel that they are helping us to protect our country, and we are very proud to have such a friend. Thank you very much, Scott. From day one, from the first days of Aero, we have a joint development with our US partners that are involved in any step of our activity of development. And more than that, since 2002, we started the co-production of the Aero missile, and we are very satisfied that it was a huge success, and it being continued with Aero 3 and with Davis Link and with Iron Dome. So we are very glad that the US companies are helping us to expedite the rate of production, and of course to help us building the right defense shield that we are needing. I mentioned the joint exercise, I mentioned that interoperability is very, very important cornerstone in our activity. Whenever we have an emergency here, US forces will be deployed and will be connected to our system. We tested the ability to have the interoperability with the US system along the years. We have a lot of exercises, either if they are a huge exercise with forces or exercises that labs are connected. And we are testing this ability along the years, and we are very confident about the multiplier that this kind of connection will give us in case of emergency. What are the recent achievements? So, with regards to system flight tests, I showed you we have ongoing improvement and flight tests with Iron Dome. We have very successful interception flight tests with Aero 3 and David's Link. With regards to assets, and this is one of our main activity right now, is to add additional Iron Dome batteries to make the production of Iron Dome more rapid, either in Rafael or in Raytheon or together. And we are having a lot of continuous upgrades to the Aero weapon system. The David's Link weapon system actually delivered for the Air Force in order to start the validation. And we are hoping that the Air Force will declare initial operation capability as soon as possible with David's Link system. And everything was done along with operational activities that the system are continue to work. What are the upcoming events? Iron Dome. We plan to have continuous production and expand capabilities and work more with Raytheon as our partners with regards to the production. With Aero 3 to conduct another flight test, interception flight test. David's Link, we are planning to do all the final preparation towards IOC and hope it will become soon. And we initiate the low rate initial production of our system. The production of Aero 3 and David's Link of the initial production capability already initiated. And we are in a major steps of to start the serial production of the Aero 3 between MLM and Boeing, and David's Link between Rafael and Raytheon. So just to summarize, as you can see here, you can see the Qader-H missile, one of them that was fired in mid-March at Iran, and it is written very clear in very accurate words in English, not in English, in Hebrew and Arabic, that Israel must be wiped out from the map. This is not the first time and not the last time that we see things like that. So this is the world that we are facing. And we think that our multi-tier defense architecture is a key element to help us counter these kind of threats. As I mentioned, we have a very productive cooperation with our US partners in the Missile Defense Agency. I can tell you I came back from a week visiting Washington DC. We have a lot of support in Congress, both houses, both parties, all administration, very, very supportive to help us building our missile defense system. We are having, investing a lot of work to do the right interoperability between our defense layers and between our system to US deployed system. We are facing a lot of technological and programmatic challenges, but this is why we are here, in order to manage and with the right cooperation with all the industries that involved and with our partners from the other side of the ocean, we believe that we will succeed. Thank you very much.